Welcome to another webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, the Fog Crawler. Today we're coming to you from our favorite campground in the whole wide world, Swimmer's Delight, here in the beautiful Redwoods. Today we're going to be sharing a recipe how to cure and smoke your own bacon.
Hi, I'm Joni. We have a new addition to the cast iron family. Dean has a Bradley smoker. And it is our hope now that we're going to give outdoor cast iron cooking a taste lift by bringing you some new things. Bacon comes to mind, cheese, some of the other things that we can do in a smoker.
Stay tuned.
Before we get cooking today, let's go back and take a look at what we did to get the pork belly to this state. This is a 15-pound pork belly. What I'm going to do is I'm going to trim up the ends and the sides, and those portions will be used for bean dishes. Nothing's going to go to waste. Then I'm going to cut 3 equal slabs, and then we'll have to remove the rind before we cure our bacon. I've got my 3 slabs. Now I'm going to flip them over and cut the rind off. I'll deep fry the bacon rind and make cracklings. And there's my pile of scraps from my trimmings. And that's going to go for pork and beans. The easiest way to get the rind off is you start in a corner and you cut it back. Then what you want to do is you work yourself over to this other side, and once you got the whole slab started, then you can just continue on down till you reach the other end. My slabs are now ready to bag up and get the brine mixed up. There's the skin, pork rind. We're going to mix up our brine mixture now. I've got my kosher salt, I've got my pink curing salt, my pepper, my crumbled bay leaves, my fresh ground nutmeg. You'll want to have a microplane to grind that stuff up. Got my brown sugar, got my almond extract. I'll wait and put this in last because I'll mix the drier ingredients together first. Then I've got my garlic, my juniper berries, and my fresh thyme. Here's the finished brine all ready to go. All I have to do is divide it up into equal parts and place it in each bag and rub it into the meat real good. The brine has been rubbed into each slab, and now they're just going to go into the refrigerator for 7 to 10 days. I can either flip them once every day or at least once midway through. The bacon slabs have been curing in the fridge for 10 days. It's time to take them out, rinse them off, and dry them off. Now we're just going to rinse it off real good with water to get all this brine off so that the bacon doesn't taste real salty. We're just going to rinse it off real good and pat it dry. We just put the bacon in the smoker. These slabs are going to smoke for 4 hours. Take a look at the bacon at the 2-hour mark. This bacon is Almond-Hickory smoked. I've used an almond extract in the cure, And if you click on the video description below where it says show more, you'll see the full recipe for this bacon. Stuff is beautiful. It's got a sweet, salty, nutty, smoky taste. It's some of the best bacon I've ever eaten. I've got the bacon sliced up. This stuff is actually quite lean. So the first thing I'm going to do is render down some of that fat that was left from the original pork belly so we can get a good fry on it. I've got a bed of coals down. I'm going to take the Griswold 14. I'm going to take a piece of this pork rind that was left over. I'm going to render down some grease. Got a good layer of grease. Now we're going to put the bacon in. I like my bacon nice and crisp, so we're going to just let this go until this thick cut bacon is nice, dark, and crispy. Really starting to look real good. Almost ready to take it off. Is your mouth watering yet? Whoever said money can't buy happiness never bought bacon. And what's better than buying bacon? Making your own bacon.
Hi, I'm Joni. How to get your dog's attention really well. Just like eating a pork chop. Oh yeah.
I'm Dean the Fog Crawler. Hope you enjoyed today's webisode. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
I'm Joni. Until the next time, happy trails to you.